Okay, today I thought I'd make a little breakfast, and it's all going to be on stored thing, prepper goods and stuff. This is a potato, just been sitting around the house for a while. I'm going to shred it. It's like a medium potato. I washed it, and but I'm not. I didn't peel it. I don't think it has. I don't think it's green in there. It doesn't look to be. So it should be okay. It's been basically in a pretty dark area. I'm going to make some hash browns, kind of a fried hash brown mixture, and some eggs. And everything's going to be powder, so this is kind of a prepping video, so to speak. And those guys there, there's probably a lot of starch and stuff extra in there. So I'm just gonna flatten that out a little bit, and it's on a paper plate. I'm just gonna squeeze some of that extra starch out, maybe a little extra moisture. Okay. Set that aside. This is my popcorn pan I've been using for popcorn, so it's got a little bit of salty, buttery stuff in it already. But that's okay. Now into this, I'm going to put whole eggs. I'm going to put, 2.5 tablespoons per egg. And I'm going to make an omelet. So, I don't really need 3 eggs. So I'm just going to do 6. 1, 2. Now these are just approximate 3, 4, 5, and 6. That's 6 tablespoons of powdered egg. Okay. That's going to be the basis for my omelet. And I'm going to put a little bit of chopped onion. Just going to sprinkle some of that out of the can. Get some onion in there. It's just, I don't know. Just for flavoring. Same thing with, The dried bell peppers. These are all Augason Farms dehydrated, diced, red, and green bell peppers. And that's probably more than enough. And to finish off the flavoring, I think I'll add a little bit of. And this is diced dried garlic. That's probably too much. And there's salt in the pan. So I'll just put some pepper. That's quite a bit of pepper, but I like a lot of pepper. So, okay. Now, to the eggs, you know you're supposed to add the equivalent in water. So I'm going to add the equivalent of the water, and then I'm going to let that soak, and then I'll start this back up. Okay, putting this aside, I put my eggs mixed them with some water. I'm putting this on 212 degrees with the heaping spoonful of coconut oil here, which I hope to fry my potatoes with. I may have to put more oil with it, but let's see if we can get by with just that. Now there, and I'm going to pepper my potatoes a bit, tiny bit of salt. A little bit of salt. Okay. A little bit of bouillon from the packet. Chicken bouillon, believe it or not. Okay. Now I've got that cooking pretty good. It's kind of bubbling. And I'm going to add this directly. There goes my spoon. I've got it. Alright. A few more straggling. I think I'm going to add a little bit of water to that. I think I will. A little bit of water. And this is on an induction stove top that I have, and I use this for making popcorn and heating up things, and especially in the summer when it gets hot. Okay. I'd like to just cover that. I think I'll just cover that. And I'll set this down to 180 degrees. I'm just going to cover that with a pie pan. And I'll be back. Fits just right. Okay. All right. Okay. Well, here we are. I'm just all right. I've been stirring this stuff up. And all that for a bit. Turning it and stirring it and what have you. Alright, I'm going to add another spoonful of oil. That's coconut oil, 100% virgin. It's got a little bit of a sweet coconutty flavor to it, which I like, and it usually doesn't impart any real flavor change to foods, or at least not a bad flavor change. Okay, I put some more pepper on this earlier. I'm just going to turn this over, and then I'm going to add my eggs around the edges so the potatoes can continue to cook as I put the eggs in. Okay. Oops. Screwing it up here. Alright. Here's my egg mixture that I've been setting aside, and that while it was rehydrating with the chili or the bell peppers and the onions and all that stuff. Okay, so that's the equivalent of probably about a little less than 3 eggs. But so now I'm just going to spread that around a little bit. Actually, what I thought of doing was putting it together and making kind of a potato egg mixture. A little bit stuck. I'm going to add a little bit more water there, and that might help loosen that up. Stainless steel gets, I don't really have these cured per se. So, I'm just going to mix that in with the potato. So it's going to be potatoes and eggs mixed. Okay. That may not look real great, but you don't eat with your eyes, so the thing is it nutritious? Does it taste good? And stuff like that. So we got onions and garlic and eggs and potatoes and oil here so far. That's what we got mixed up here. I don't know if that'll go down. I'm putting that down to 140 now. I'm just going to mix that up real good. Cover it for a couple minutes. And it should be done, basically. An egg mixture. An egg omelet type of meal. Spread that out a little bit, and there we go. I'm gonna cover that 140 degrees. And we'll get back. Okay, now we're back. Not really all that hot. Stir this stuff around a little bit. Kind of got itself unstuck and being there on low. Okay. So this should have all the flavors and stuff of hash browns and a 3 egg omelet with no meat. Let's try it out. It's pretty tasty. You can taste that kind of sweetness, and lots of good calories, and lots of good goodness here. Okay, now all you gotta do is eat it. Now at this point, I could put some dehydrated freeze-dried Colby cheese on it, or I could sprinkle some of my popcorn salt, which is basically dried powdered cheddar. Okay, and I think I'm going to use that, and then you could use that, you mix that with some fermented salsa, jarred or canned salsa, or something to that effect. That'll give it some cheesy flavor there, I think. Maybe a little parmesan would be good, but I'm not gonna snuck in the best of time or effort to go get that. There you go. That's now it should be a little cheesy. Let's taste. Yum. Okay, that's a definite improvement. Okay, this is tasty. It's good. It's easy to do. And everything is dried or preserved or stored that's in it. Okay. So it's a good prepper breakfast for two, basically. Or one good hungry man. And with that, I'm going to sign off. This is GT here. Everybody prep.